Hey guys, it's Workerpers, and welcome to my brand new FIFA 16 secondary career mode. This time, I am in League 1 with Olympique Marseille. Because, why not? Yes, of course I'm doing a French career mode. Why wouldn't I? Because I've done pretty much every year, or major, or league. Equal only French League, and La Liga remaining. So, and Marseille were up before, or the La Liga team, which you could probably guess anyway. Yes, it is Barca. But that's not what we're here to talk about. We are here to talk about this brand new term. We can see, I've already made one change to the Marseille team. Remy Cabella, he handed in a transfer request, which I really wasn't expecting. I didn't anticipate that. I hadn't any plans to sell, or I didn't have any plans to sell him, to be honest. Like, my first instinct was to get a new right back, because it was the right back. If any Marseille fans are watching, you know it's what that fucking twit who was on loan at Liverpool, and I just, considering how bad he was at Liverpool, I just couldn't stomach him for this whole season. I got the wheel relatively cheap, 8 mil for a very decent right back. You know, it's not a deal he sneezed at, but all of a sudden I get, I'm assuming for preseason, all of a sudden I get a transfer request from Cabella, and I'm like, huh.
Well, they can be
now at this point, I haven't made any decisions on how I want to play with how I want to use the team, how I want structure the team. All I know is I got the right back I wanted. Yeah, I could have gone for a different right back, but I haven't used Van der Wiel in about three FIFAs. I think FIFA 13, maybe FIFA 12 was actually the last time I used him. And of course, he was a much younger, different player then. I brought him to Marseille, why not? 8 million. And I got him. I didn't have to, like, super get into negotiations with him. Like, I didn't have to offer him crazy amount of money. I offered him what he asked for, or he accepted straight away. It was always going to be pretty easy to assign it to someone who isn't getting their game at their main club, but will, you know, go straight into your starting 11, and it's good enough to go straight into your starting 11. That's why it's good to look at the teams who sometimes finish above you. If there's teams that finish above you, always, you know, have a little look-see, you know, at their team. Assess their team and see, you know, is there a player who might fit into your team who they might not want, who they don't rate highly enough. And obviously with the
Mendy,
PSG obviously have that in the form of Mr. Van der Wiel.
Oh, in goes the cross. Fletcher, Marseille score here.
And way, there we go. There's the first goal of this career mode. 28 minutes. And Stephen Fletcher,
what a strike that was.
Bags the first goal of the career mode.
Defenders caught out in the end.
I think this is the first time I'm ever using Stephen Fletcher in a career mode on any FIFA. So I was a bit skeptical. I was considering replacing him. I'm not gonna BS. I'm not gonna be around the bush and say I wasn't gonna replace him. I totally was. I was like, Not exactly too keen on a very quite an old striker as well. But I said, you know what? I'll give Fletcher a chance. I'll put him in the squad for the preseason and see if he can change my mind. And lo and behold, he was the top goal scorer in the preseason tournament and scored in pretty much every game. I was like, oh, okay, I guess he's good enough. And there you go, he's also continued that form into the team. And this
for the free kick.
The first goal of the season. And these guys are really going in on their challenges. That's two free kicks, pretty much in the same general area. They're gonna regret giving me these chances with Hakan Çalhanoğlu, who is who I brought in to replace Cabella. I was racking my brain, trying to think of a central attacking midfielder who might be a good signing, who I hadn't used yet in FIFA. I was like, I could use someone I've already used. Boost is as I make it 2-0. Fantastic. It's actually Batshuayi, who shouldn't even be at Marseille. And yes, I am aware he shouldn't be here, but when I updated the squad, it didn't move him to Chelsea. So what can I do?
Take another look at the goal.
I updated the squad, the game didn't update it. This is the
starting at 2-0.
Marseille squad it gave me, with the exception of Manquillo not at right back and Cabella not a cam. Actually, I had to change the formation because they were playing 4-4-2 with two defensive midfielders. And I don't mind playing with one defensive midfielder. I mean, it's not exactly my preferred position because, you know, there's not really a lot of options in central, well, defensive midfielder or for a great player you can have in your team. But I was like, okay. Obviously, Diarra is A3. He rated. He's gonna be a fantastic player. I am trying to sign someone to give him competition. Someone to test his mental. See how much he wants to be in this first team. Cause you know, it's just some friendly competition. And I've never really rated Islot really high. You know, I've done a few Juventus career modes, and in almost every Juventus career mode I've done, when he was at Juventus, I sell him because I just don't rate him as a midfielder or a defender. He just doesn't seem like he fits anything. Like this is like his third different position, because he was originally a right mid, then he was a right back. Now he's a CDM. He just can't make up his fucking mind. He doesn't know what he wants to be. He's like a young kid who can't decide what job they want to grow up and become. One day, they want to be a fireman. One day, they want to be a policeman. Then they want to be a superhero. Oh, and you know that's fine for kids. Kids can, you know, kids are imaginative, and hell, they could become policemen, they could be
good tackle.
Firemen, and there's nothing stopping either of those from happening. I mean, they just have to put in the work when they're older. They also have to acknowledge that there would be the situation where you... Hang on, who's he booking? Is he booking me? Yeah, who did he? Oh, I saw for a second there he booked Hakan Çalhanoğlu. I was like, what did I do? Oh, that one went straight in. But yeah, he's not really my kind of player. And I was like, if I'm gonna have fun, I mean, really enjoy a central defensive mid. I've never really liked Diarra either. I mean, I used him. I used him in a career mode I did with Real Madrid back when he used to play for Real Madrid. And I couldn't enjoy playing with him. He seemed very, not that he's ever been the fastest player, but he's not really, he's just, something about him just didn't scream that he will work for me. Now, I'm not gonna, sell him, I'm not gonna replace him instantly, but he will have to prove that he wants this position, because the player I'm bringing in, I have high respect for. He's one of my favorite players. There is a little bias because he used to play for Liverpool. Well, he's a fantastic player, always will be. Maybe one day he'll come back to Liverpool, even in a coaching role. He's more than welcome to do that. I don't care. Or if he just wants to sit in the crowd and watch every game, that's fine too. But just to have him back at
the ball before striking the shot,
pretty much where he belongs, He's played for other teams, but I mean, Liverpool made him. He and Liverpool both helped each other become better.
He's got his block in, and the cross doesn't get into the middle.
And of course, if you're a regular,
he's had a go.
If you've been a long-time subscriber, you might remember when I talked about him possibly coming back in a previous transfer rumors video. And of course, if you're a Liverpool fan, you might have pieced together who I am talking about. Of course, it is Xabi Alonso, who I got to this position. Of course, with the secondary career modes, I always like to do the preseason off camera, and then I stop just before the first game, and then I show the games that will mean something to the career mode in its entirety when it's all said and done. As Hakan Çalhanoğlu gets a goal on his Marseille debut, and this is actually his debut. He only signed only a few days before this match, so great way to get to make yourself known amongst your new fans, right in front of them as well.
Very comfortable margin for victory.
So no one starting off with a dominating goal performance, a goal for each striker and my central attacking midfielder, to give a nice 3-0 win and some great start to the career mode. And it looks like that will put me top of the table, because there are 2-0 wins. Yep, there it is.
GFC Ajaccio.
And see, some of the other results have left some of the bigger, some of the big rivals that I'll have to look out for throughout the season, perhaps. Like PSG and Monaco. And yes, PSG will have Ibra. Sorry, Man United fans. I updated the squad and the game didn't put him to Man United. It's not my fault. We'll deal with it. Oh, I got an offer for Isla. West Ham, huh? You see my transfer budget. I got a bit of money for no reason. I think the club might have been taken over. Or I didn't use a financial takeover, but I just randomly had this money. I didn't get a lot from Cabela, of course, because he handed in a transfer request. So I couldn't exactly get too much money out of him. I mean, 2.9 isn't that much under his valuation. It's only 500k, and that 500k is not really going to be too big of an issue. And look at this guy. He's like, yo, give me Cabello's spot. Yeah, you're a bit late to the party there, friend. Someone else is already taking it. That's how new Chonalogo is. So the other players haven't even realized he's the replacement for Cabella. But that guy is gonna feature as probably on my bench. I did sign Mustier on a transfer to be like backup for the second team. So this is what the second team is gonna look like. I also got in Munir and Dungu. Probably butchering his name. Sorry about that. But yeah, they're here as well. They're gonna, cause when I start the career mode, for those of you who play career mode, and you'll know, when you start a career mode, the board, they say, here is, like, you should consider signing a player in such and such a position. And the position they said was striker. And I was thinking, when I looked at the squad, I was like, maybe they're telling me that I should replace Stephen Fletcher. So I'm like, I'll assess Stephen Fletcher and then I'll see where I want to go with that. But Stephen Fletcher obviously played very well to the point where I'm like, yo, I don't need to replace him. So I'm like, okay, I usually want to sign the player, like a player in the position that the board suggests, so I don't make them mad. I wouldn't want, you know, them to think, oh, I'm disrespecting them by not signing a player in the position that they recommended. So I did sign two strikers, so I'm like, there, job done. And of course, why not? Oh, freaking course. You see some of the other options I considered as possible midfielders. Max Meyer. That was high on my... He was high on my potential targets list, I'm not gonna lie. I'm gonna say right now, if I hadn't... It's almost like he got a bit unlucky that right under him was Hakan Çalhanoğlu. I'm like, oh yeah, the guy with the best free kicks in the game, even better than Cristiano Ronaldo. Oh. Then again, I can't back that up. I don't know what his, I know his free kicks were good on our previous FIFA. I don't know what they are in this game. Oops. Oh. If I was doing it the right 94. I mean, if that's not higher than Ronaldo's, then it's gotta be very freaking close. Ronaldo's might be 96 or 95 or some shit like that. Speaking of Cristiano Ronaldo, check out my Liverpool career mode video from Sunday. Hey, yes, that is a shameless plug. I'll deal with it. But, anyway, I'm not too bothered about Cristiano Ronaldo's free kicks anymore. Because I finally scored one on camera. I had scored two before. One in Ultimate Team with Ronaldo. And one in a... Excuse me. One in an off-screen career mode with that I do with Bradford, with a guy like named Paul Anderson or something. I don't. If you don't know the Bradford team, you're not gonna know who the fuck that is. To be fair, I didn't fucking know who he was either. Or Bradford was, you know, randomly picked. So, yeah. And, in my last Liverpool career mode, I had a free kick with Chris Down, although I hit it, and he scored!
The opposition back off, they could be in trouble. And the ball gets to here.
And that's all I will say. He go watch the video for yourself to see the free kick, see what it was given for, what was the result of the kick in terms of any cards given, and the result of the match, of course, and what did for the Premier League table.
Well, he's got the ball there and dealt with the danger, really.
So that's the same shameless plug out of the way. Hey, that's done. Now I can focus on the second game of the season, the first away game, hoping to make it 2 wins from 2.
Manager, instant impact. That's often the case, of course, but now it's the second competitive game in his jurisdiction.
I noticed I have a few young players in the starring lineup, which was interesting. Like, I instantly recognized Rekic, I think it's not pronounced.
That's a good challenge between the two of them.
But yeah, I was like, oh, isn't that the Man City youngster? And the only reason I know he's a Man City youngster is because I signed him in a previous career mode on a different FIFA after he had finished a loan and returned to Manchester City. So I was like, oh, it's him. And I also signed him in a Football Manager career mode as well.
Cool.
Of course, Football Manager is done a little different in the course.
Stephen Fletcher. Good forward play this from Marseille. Oh, in goes the cross. Counter-attack could be on here, because it was a poor ball. Got some free possession and a chance to get numbers forward. That's a turnover to the opposition.
Fletcher.
Goal kick here.
Pass away. What was that? That was a terrible header. Yo, do Chelsea know what they've gotten themselves into? Right now, you're... that is Diego Costa was last season.
And this team in pain around 55.
That fucker got dropped half the time.
Turnover of possession here.
How?
Good, this move.
It's not going to be good enough, Bashaboy. I may remind you, there's still a few days in the transfer window, and I have some money. So, you know, pick up your shit. I know how to deal with lazy-ass strikers who can't put the ball on the net on a regular, consistent basis. You threaten to replace them. I will get a striker who can replace you like that. You probably didn't hear me snap my fingers.
Well blocked.
For some reason, it's not as loud as some people can do it. I can't do it. Like, I'd have to hold it, like, super close to the mic for you to be able to hear it.
Spectacularly.
No, neither here nor there. But what is here is a goal from Tovan. I want to say formerly of Newcastle, or is he on loan from Newcastle? I don't know. I don't understand Newcastle's transfers sometimes. Like, he watched YouTuber The True Jordy, and even him explaining it, I still don't understand if Tovan is gone back on loan, or if he's gone And to be fair, the true Georgie, he speaks a lot of gibberish. I think he'll... he's not gonna see this. If he does, hello, true Georgie. Randomly, not sure why you came to the channel, but cheers, mate.
Perhaps a better response from his
randomly, if he's there, he's probably not. He's fucking...
1-0 here as the halftime whistle goes.
I can probably say with confidence that he's not. I'll look when this fucking post, and I'll see a fucking comment to the true Georgie, and I'll be like, yeah, that's not him. That's not him. There's a very good chance it'll be a fake.
Team's all set, and we're ready.
But yeah, Tovan, the,
Charbonnier.
One time, on loan, shit ex Newcastle player. Whatever the fuck he is, scores and opens the scoring, making that four different people I have scored with in this career mode so far. Adding to the goals from Fletcher, Bashawai, and Chanalogu in the last game. Which means I have not had found my consistent score yet. Still time, still time. I'm not going to jump to conclusions, but I want to see better or shooting and header from some of the strikers. Bashawai.
Well, it didn't quite cause the problems that it looked as though it would, that cross. And now the defending team can play their way out of trouble.
No way I'm going to pronounce that guy's name. Wow, they all have really hard names to say. Like, except for, like, one. Whose name is Traore, the guy over here. Verse 27. The guy who just found me. Or he didn't.
This is it.
And this fair enough, referee. You'll be able to see making that. Shit up now. Oh, as you go along, fair play.
Well, it's the goal. And that's at the goalkeeper. Not really what the attacker had in mind.
Shui can't prevent the keeper from getting his clearance on the pitch. Tovan. Or is it Tovan?
Diarra.
I'm going to go with how I heard the true Geordie pronounce it in Tovan.
DeVoe.
Chanlogu. Fletcher.
Fletcher.
Straight at the keeper. Really? It's like they're all allergic to scoring a second goal in this career mode so far.
Can they do it in these closing minutes?
He's laying to the hands of Steve Mandanda, who doesn't even play for Marseille anymore. I'm not sure where he went.
By the way, the center half's going forward.
Can somebody answer in the comments section below? I know Bashawai went to Chelsea. I know Mandanda left Marseille on a free transfer, but I don't know where he went. If he has got a new club yet, I don't know why he wouldn't. He's a fantastic keeper. Tovan! Straight at the keeper again. I'm gonna have to start sweating it a lot. More instead of taking the first
time
option shot.
Here, and they haven't got too much of it left to deal in. The fans, though,
use my options to the best of my ability.
That they don't launch long balls forward, that they keep the patience and try and fashion an opening. They're definitely in an attacking frame of mind. Look at the throw. Stephen Fletcher. Gonna cross it. Well, the ball deserved,
perhaps. Ah, I thought that was the opportunity.
The defender got there first, though. Here's Fletcher.
Yes! No! How did you miss? Oh, Fletcher, that was your opportunity. Oh, that was one of the best opportunities of the game. And I've scored in this game. Damn. I really thought that header was going to go in. Well, it's a successful start. I can't argue with two wins.
Liga earned. Lorient 3.
No, Bastia, definitely can't. Two.
Paris Saint-Germain 4.
So yeah.
GFC Ajaccio 0. Stade de Reims 0.
Two wins. That's a thing. Great start. Yeah. I'll. He's declined again. Oh yeah, I remember Tovan actually asked to play in that match. Ironically, he scored in it. Did he know he was gonna do that? One must wonder. I guess this will be my last contract offer to Xavi, because, you know, if he doesn't want to come, I'm not gonna force him to do anything. But, you know, rule 3, gotta make an offer. Ah! Yes, this is interesting, isn't it? If I was going to consider selling Batshuayi, I would only consider selling him to the team he went to in real life, and for around about the same money. I think it was about 30 million or something like that, that he went to Chelsea for, so if Chelsea come in, I'll try and get the same money out of them and quickly get a replacement. I can get a replacement in no time because I can make a star out of anyone. You know this, the deal by now. Okay, Alonso just doesn't want to come. Fair enough. And I have a 17-year-old striker going to Coventry. And that's going to be the end of this video. With all those dogs barking, ruining the end of this video. Oh, sorry about that. Don't know how to cut that out, so if you heard that, yeah, sorry about that. That is not exactly how you want to end the first video of a new career. In the next episode, I'll have two more league matches against Troyes, and Yag. Yes. Top class pronunciation there. So, yeah. If you're excited for this new career mode, make sure to smash the like button, subscribe if you're new to the channel, also you don't miss the rest of his career mode and any future videos that I might do in the future. And until next time, I hope you all have a very